Say hi.
Can everybody please take their seat? Glad you're here today.
Told you she's gonna be late. And the bride is unusually late. Ain't that right, Karen? I told him last week she'll be here just a little late.
Okay, here they come.
Joey.
want to welcome everyone to this wonderful day as we come together to witness the marriage of Troy Walters and Tiffany Carlock. I know the Lord's with us here today, so let's bow our heads and let's ask His blessing for what we're about to do. Our Heavenly Father, we desire to acknowledge You in every step we take in life. And Lord, this is especially true on this day. This is the wedding day of Troy and Tiffany. We thank You, Lord, for the love that unites them and the beauty of the marriage ceremony. Lord, we're also thankful that we witnesses here today, it's not just a ritual, but it's a wonderful celebration of joining together of two people who know Jesus Christ as their Lord and who've been brought together by You, God. You've brought them together. Father, we also acknowledge that it's within Your providence and within Your plan, and it's also a wonderful ceremony in Your sight. Help us to be aware of the covenant that's being made here today. We pray that You'd bless this time and bless all those who share in it, and we ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're glad you're here today. You can be seated.
Hold this for a second.
You ready to do this?
No, wait.
You know, we've come here today in the presence of God to join in holy matrimony, Troy and Tiffany. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, it's the little things that really are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It's never going to sleep angry. It's at no time taking each other for granted. You know, the courtship shouldn't end with the honeymoon. It should continue throughout the years. It's really having a sense of values and common objectives. It's really standing together and facing this tough world, isn't it? It's forming a circle of love that gathers the whole family together. It's doing things for each other. Not in the attitude of it's a sacrifice, but in the joy of the Spirit. It's speaking words of appreciation and really demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways throughout the week. It's not expecting the husband to wear a halo or to expecting the wife to have wings like an angel. It's really not looking for perfection in each other. It's cultivating flexibility and patience and understanding, and always trying to have a sense of humor. It's having the capacity to forgive and to forget. It's giving each other an atmosphere in which we can grow in. It's finding room for the things of the Spirit. It's a common search for the good and for the beautiful things in life. It's really establishing a relationship in which independence is equal and independence is mutual and obligation is reciprocal. It's not only marrying the right partner, but it's being the right partner. You know, the Bible teaches that the marriage is God's first institution. It's an important institution. You know, in the Garden of Eden, before the forbidden tree had yielded its fateful fruit, or the tempter had touched its inhabitants, God looked upon man and He determined that it wasn't good for man to be alone. Then in God's wisdom and God's grace, He made him a partner, a helpmate for him. And the scripture says this in Genesis 2, it says, "Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib and brought her to Adam." So God established the human family, and even as all of heaven looked on, you know, marriage was originated in divine grace, and it was designed to promote human happiness. You know, the vows of marriage are holy. They're holy in God's sight, and they're going to remain the foundation of your home life and the social order of all of your life until Jesus Christ comes to institute a new order for mankind. Let me ask you, who gives this bride to be married today? You do too. All right. So if you, Troy, and you, Tiffany, have freely and deliberately chosen each other as partners in this holy estate, and and you know of no reason why you should not be united in marriage, then I'd like you to come up here and let's join hands. How's that? So, Troy, if you'll take Tiffany's hand. Let's take her right hand first. Troy had taken Tiffany by the right hand in token of your desire to have her as your lawful wedded wife before God and before all the witnesses present here today. I want you to repeat this after me, okay? Tiffany, I promise, to love, honor, and cherish you.
To love, honor, and cherish you.
Leaving all others and cleave to you.
Leaving all others and cleave to you.
To be to you in all things,
a
true and faithful husband.
As long as we both shall live.
For richer and even poorer.
For better,
for worse,
in
sickness and in health. Until death separates us. Now, Tiffany, if you'll take Troy by the right hand and the token of your desire to have him as your lawful wedded husband before God and before all the witnesses present here today, I want you to repeat after me. You ready? Troy, I promise to love, honor, and cherish you. Leaving all others and cleaving to you, to be to you in all things, a true and faithful wife, as long as we both shall live, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, in sickness and in health, until death separates us. That's good. Okay, so you're present here today because you love each other, right? This is one of the most joyous and significant days that you'll ever have in your life. You've had the excitement of dating and the excitement of falling in love and being engaged. And now the day you've planned for, your wedding day, is finally here. It's the day you've dreamed about. It's the day you've worked towards. Today's your wedding day. It's a special day. Gathered here with you are your family and your friends and really the people who love you the most, people that you share your life with. And I thank you for the opportunity to be a part of the ceremony too. But, you know, I talked to both of you in preparation before the marriage day, and I asked you a few things that drew you to each other. And Troy, Tiffany said that it was your compassion and your generosity and the fact that you really love her unconditionally.
Hold on, Tammy.
The fact also that you love God, that was important to her. Each of you have indicated that you appreciate the Christian spirit in each of you. You feel that you're God's gift to each other. This is really an awesome beginning of a great relationship that you're going to share joy, and you're going to probably share some hardships, but you're going to carry each other arm in arm through life. God has a plan for your life. We talked about that a while ago. It's a plan to prosper you and to give you a hope and a future. It's an incredible privilege to feel that you found exactly the person God intended for you to spend the rest of your life with. I want to tell you today that God, in front of God and in front of all these witnesses, that the Bible says in Joshua chapter 24, verse 15, it says, "But as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord." And that's a declaration that y'all made today. So it's an incredible privilege to feel that you found exactly the right person that God intended for you to spend the rest of your life with. So I tell you, let's exchange the rings. You got the rings? So, tell you what, I'm going to give you that one. I'm going to give you this one. So in the spirit of love, you're going to be signifying your relationship today by exchanging rings. Rings are really just the outward visible sign of the invisible commitment that you're making to the Lord Jesus and you're making to each other today. As you exchange these rings, I ask you to be aware of how they really portray the ideal marriage, because that's what the marriage is all about. The circle of rings has no beginning and no end, and it really represents wholeness for the sense of eternity. The metal in the rings represents the purity of your relationship. So Troy, if you'll place this ring on the third finger of your bride's left hand and repeat these vows after me. With this ring, I thee wed. With all my worldly goods, I thee endow. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, Tiffany, if you'll do likewise, if you'll place that ring on the third finger of your groom's left hand, that shaking left hand. If you'll repeat these vows. You ready to repeat these vows? There you go. With this ring, I thee wed. With all my worldly goods, I thee endow. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So here's what we're going to do next. We're going to let y'all come over here and mix the unity sand. Just start mixing.
Sherry, hold that. Just hold it just like that towards them.
Let me say a prayer. Let's bow our heads. Father, now as Troy and Tiffany dedicate themselves to each other and to you, I pray that the love between them will grow sweeter with the passing of each day and each year. May they always trust each other, and in perfect confidence may they trust in you, Lord. I thank you for the mystery of marriage that they're going to discover. You know, mysteriously, it cuts sorrow in half because there are two to share the burden, but it doubles the joy because there are two to share the joyful experiences. So from the depths of my heart, I offer petitions for two things for their home. I pray that Jesus Christ will always be acknowledged in their home.
Amen.
And I pray that laughter will always ring from their home each day of the year, really signifying the happiness and the joy of the people that live in that home. Father, may we ask your blessing on this couple as they begin to build a life together. May it be a life of mutual respect, encouraging each other to the best they can to be for your sake. And now may the grace and mercy and the peace of God and the fellowship of His Holy Spirit rest on each of them for now and forevermore. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, for as much as Troy and Tiffany have agreed to gather according to the teachings of the Scripture and the laws of this great state, I, as a minister of the gospel, declare that they are husband and wife. And let no one separate them, for God has joined them together. Don't forget. Let no one separate them, for God's joined them together. And now, Troy, you may kiss your bride. Introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Troy Walter. Yeah.
wonderful day.